Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're actually just going to go over a very popular investment vehicle that probably gets recommended to a lot of beginners and a lot of people who are new to the stock market, and that's ETFs or exchange traded funds. So for today's video, we're just going to go over what they are, how they work, and stay tuned to the end because then I'll just go over some of the benefits that come with investing in an ETF. Now, if you are new here, I do make videos every week just talking about personal finance and investing and really just helping you get better with your money. So before we do carry on, do consider liking the video and subscribe to the channel. It is free, but it does help out quite a bit. So click the like button down below. And with that being said, let's get on to what an ETF is. So an ETF is an exchange traded fund. Now, what the hell is that? Basically, to break it down, we'll just break down the term itself. So exchange traded just means that it's traded on the major stock exchanges. So it can be bought and sold like any other stock of an individual company. Now, to understand the fund part of this, I'll briefly go over what a mutual fund is. So a fund is basically an investment vehicle whereby a whole lot of investors pull together a bunch of money, and then that money is used to invest into things like stocks, bonds, commodities, all across the different asset groups, right? Now, usually with a mutual fund, all that money that's pulled together will go to a professional money manager who's actually then going to decide how and what to invest in. And their job basically is to bring you better than average returns, right? Because a mutual fund, generally, they will be charging fees. So they'll take something like 2% flat rate, and then they'll also take a percentage of the profits. And you're paying them these fees so that he could actually then outperform the market or bring back better returns than the market is currently bringing. Also with the mutual fund, it's not traded on the stock exchanges. So you can't just go and buy, you know, one share of a mutual fund, you know, whenever you feel like it. It's actually only, you can only buy it once per day, and that's after the trading's closed, right? So at the end of the day, basically. A really simple and kind of common example of a mutual fund is something like your KiwiSaver or your 401k, right? So all that money that's getting pulled together that you're contributing, that your fellow colleagues are contributing from their salaries and from their wages, that obviously all goes towards, maybe it's not one money manager, but it does go towards the professional money managers, and then they will invest that money for you, and you'll obviously be paying them fees, and in return for those fees, they're supposed to bring back above average returns or outperform the market, right? So that's a mutual fund. So an ETF or an exchange traded fund is different from a mutual fund in the sense that it is traded on the stock exchanges, so you can actually go and buy a share of an ETF right now, in the morning, later night, trade it, buy it, sell it however you want, just like any other company. And also an ETF is structured in a way that it's not actually, the money that's pulled together doesn't actually go to a professional money manager, but rather an ETF is designed to track a specific index. Or it can track things like the price of gold, it can track specific sectors, it can track currencies, whatever it is, an ETF is designed to track those underlying assets. So what is an index? An index basically is used by people to kind of track the performance of a particular group of stocks or a particular sector. So for example, there is the very popular S&P 500 index, right? Standard & Poor's 500 index. And that's just an index that tracks the performance of the top 500 largest companies in the United States, right? So all that index does is, so say for example, you're wondering how the US market is currently performing, how it's doing, instead of, you know, guessing and wondering by looking at the charts of different companies, you can actually look up the S&P 500 index, which is the largest 500 companies in the United States, and use that as a benchmark to how the market is performing. So that index tracks the overall performance of those 500 companies. Now that's just one index, right? There's an index that tracks the price of gold, there's an index that tracks, you know, tech companies. Basically, an index is a basket of companies, and you just want to go to an index to track the performance of those companies, right? So an ETF, basically how it's structured is it's designed to follow the performance of an index, right? So as another example, the same index, right? The S&P 500. If you want to buy an ETF that tracks the performance of the 500 companies, you will then go to and buy something like the Vanguard's S&P 500 ETF, which the ticker symbol is VOO, right? So if you buy one share of VOO, essentially what happens is that ETF will then go out and buy a small portion of all those companies for you. So you essentially now, by buying that one share, you now have a small ownership stake in all of those 500 companies, right? And now, instead of relying on a money manager or one person's decisions to beat the market, all you're doing now is just participating in the market and tracking the performance of the market. So whatever those 500 companies as a whole bring back, that's what your investment's going to bring back. So if you look up the performance of those 500 companies, that's essentially going to be the returns that your portfolio will bring back. To put some context into this, the S&P 500 over the last 100 years historically has brought back an average of around 8 to 9%, right? So that's what you can get from investing in an S&P 500 index. Now, the S&P 500 isn't the only option that you have. Say you actually then want to go, want to narrow it down a bit more, want to niche it down a bit more, and maybe start investing in a sector or an industry that you believe in a bit more, you're really interested in. You know, there's an ETF that tracks tech companies, which if you follow tech at the moment, it probably has been performing extremely well over the last couple of years. There is a index that tracks all tech companies. There's an index that tracks biotech companies. There's an index that tracks, if you're really bullish on gold, silver. There's an index that tracks things like that, of that nature. Basically, there's an index for almost anything. So your portfolio can have a theme of investments in a sense. So you might be wondering, why should I invest in ETFs? What's the big deal? What's the benefits of investing with them in an ETF, right? So the first quick benefit of an ETF is that it kind of maximizes your returns by minimizing your fees, right? So with a mutual fund, you're obviously gonna be paying fees like the 2% that the flat rate that they have, and then they're obviously gonna take a portion of the, most mutual funds will take a percentage of the profits as well. Now, 2% doesn't sound like a whole lot, but as I mentioned in a previous video discussing, the effects of fees on a fund, 2% can end up taking away, overall 40% worth of your returns, because that 2% does compound over time, and all that money that you're paying in fees is not actually going into the market and compounding for you. So it really adds up really quick. And on top of that, you're paying these fees because they're supposed to actually outperform the market for you. But if you do look up the overall track performance of mutual funds over the last decade, over the last 20 years, it doesn't actually look very good. In fact, majority, if not most of them, actually end up underperforming the market. Right, so that's one benefit of an ETF. So another benefit of an ETF is that it is very cost effective in the sense that, you can actually diversify your portfolio. If you want to buy a whole bunch of companies, you don't have to go out and buy them individually, right? Imagine trying to buy all 500 of the companies that's in the S&P 500, right? All the brokerage fees, all the, if you're in New Zealand like myself, all the exchange rate fees, that is going to add up, and it's just going to eat any returns that you're going to make. And overall, it's going to have a pretty bad effect on your returns. And so by buying, one share of the S&P 500 index, you basically get that all those 500 companies under that one transaction. So very cost effective in that way, and it also lead into the next benefit of buying a index fund, and that is diversification, right? So obviously diversification, you will hear this a lot if you are new to investing or if you're someone that just wants to be a passive investor. It is really important to diversify your portfolio and not put all of your eggs in one basket, right? If you have a very concentrated portfolio, of 3 to 4 stocks, it's basically, if anything happens to one of those companies, your portfolio will take a massive hit. By diversifying, essentially you're kind of offsetting the winners and the losers because you've got your money so spread out through so many different companies, right? So for example, if the price of Apple for whatever reason decides to drop down 80%, your portfolio is not going to take the full grunt of that 80%, because you'll have companies like Netflix, Amazon, or all the other favorites. They'll obviously be performing well, so they'll be holding up your portfolio, and you're not going to feel the full grunt of that fall from Apple. So ETFs is a great way to diversify your portfolio if you're not someone who's willing to do the work to actually pick individual stocks and research individual companies, right? You just want to put your money into the market. Like I mentioned, the market has brought back an average return of 8 to 9% over the last 100 years. So if you are someone that's investing for the long term but not necessarily wanting to be the next Warren Buffett, put your money in an ETF, and you can then have that diversification and leave your money in there to work for you. So that's another benefit of investing in an ETF. And that brings me to the final benefit that I want to go over today with investing in ETFs, and that's simply it takes away all of the stress and the emotion from investing. So with a passive investing strategy or an index investing strategy, it is a very robotic process. Basically, all you're going to do is you're going to put your money into the market, you're going to buy that ETF, whatever it is that you decide you're buying, you're going to leave it there and you're going to forget about it, right? Because you're investing for the long term, it doesn't really matter what the price of that ETF does in the next 1 year or 2 years. It's a set it and forget it strategy, and it's a strategy for the long term. And because you're doing it that way, you're not really worried about what the market is doing. You're not really worried about what any individual company is doing or what the Fed is doing with printing money and whatnot, because you know you have a very long time horizon. And data throughout history is on your side, showing that if you leave your money in the market long term to compound, it will grow over time. With this investment strategy, with this passive investment strategy, you're not really stressed or worried about, you know, picking individual companies or making sure you have the winners, because picking winners is extremely hard. You know, in Warren Buffett's last annual meeting, the Berkshire Hathaway meeting, he brought up a very good example where he put up a list of the current 20 largest companies in the world, right? And in those 20 largest companies, you see very familiar names. You know, you see Apple, Amazon, you know, all those big names. But then he also then put up a list of companies, the 20 largest companies 20 or 30 years ago. And you'll actually see that none of the companies that were on the list 30 years ago are on the list today. And he did that to prove a point. And the point is that it's very hard to pick winners, right? There are companies 30 years ago that, you know, you would have thought, you know, you're crazy to think that this company is going to go under, or you're crazy to think this company is going to be worth 1/8 of what it is today. But it does happen, and changes do happen very drastically. So if you're someone that does want to have to stress or deal with the, you know, the stress of picking those winners, because it takes a lot of time, it does take a lot of knowledge to do so, then, you know, index investing is perfect for you, right? You just put your money in the market once a year, once every 6 months, whatever it is, you set it and forget it. And no matter what the price of the market is at the time, you're just gonna show up and buy it every single time, and you just leave it alone to compound, right? So that's another benefit of ETF or passive investing. Now guys, that is the video today. You know, if you enjoyed the video or got some value out of the video, please do like the video. It's just down there. It helps out a bunch, and subscribe to the channel. Turn on your notifications for more videos like this. And if you did enjoy the content, if you do enjoy the content, click on the screen right now. I'll have other videos that are on the channel that should help you learn a little bit more about investing. Until then, we'll see you guys in the next one.